Did you call bank? I called game.
So if you've noticed, PlayStation has released NBA Live 18 for straight up less than $5. That is actually a steal for a game that no one actually cares about. $5 is pretty cheap for a game that was like 60 bucks a couple days ago. And in this video, I want to talk about the roster ratings in NBA 2K18 and compare them for NBA Live 18. What is up, Pack Nation? It's Pack Gaming here. And in this video, I'm going to get players that NBA Live believes are really good, but 2K thinks are bad. And let's get this list started at number 10 with Tony Parker, one of the winningest players in the NBA with 5 championships, more than anybody in the NBA with Manu Ginobili. NBA Live thinks Tony Parker is an 81 overall, while NBA 2K18 believes Tony Parker is a 76 overall. Now, Tony right now is averaging 8 points per game in the Spurs that are still winning games, so I see where the NBA Live is coming from, but I also understand 2K is saying, hey, he averages 8 points a game. Also, he's getting old and his defense isn't going to be as good now that he's old. So, I see the argument on both sides. At number 9, it is Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. NBA Live believes he's an 81 overall, while 2K believes he's a 76 overall. Now, Kentavious Caldwell-Pope's averaging 13 points per game on a struggling Lakers, and I think people believed he was going to be much, much better than what he is right now. But 2K, I do believe, kind of gives him a rough rating. I also don't believe he's an 81 overall, but I do think he deserves to be somewhere in the middle of that. At number 8, it is JJ Redick. So this is the first time on this list I'm going to agree with NBA Live. He is an 83 in NBA Live, while he is a 78 in 2K. JJ Redick is actually, believe it or not, averaging 17 points per game for the Philadelphia 76ers, the process. I actually didn't know he was averaging so much, and he's actually being really helpful to the team. Sure, he can't play defense because, well, he's just short, not as athletic as many guards in the league, but he's a veteran, he's consistent, great three-point shooter. I think he definitely deserves to have something like an 80-something. At number 7, it is Avery Bradley. I'm going to actually agree with 2K on this time. Avery Bradley's an 84 overall in NBA Live, while he's a 79 overall in 2K. He's averaging 9 points per game, and this is one of his most struggled seasons in his past couple seasons. He was doing great with the Celtics, one of the best defenders in the league, did okay with Detroit, but not really good, and now is doing really bad with the Clippers. So, I think that 79 rating is kind of appropriate. At number 6, it is Drew Holiday. He is an 85 overall in NBA Live and an 80 overall in 2K. So, this one's kind of eh. Drew Holiday has been on fire lately. He's having one of his best seasons. He's having the best season he's ever had, averaging 19 points per game. And lately, he's averaging like 25 a game. He's been doing really solid. I think he definitely deserves that like 85, maybe even an 84 rating. At number 5, it is Isaiah Thomas. Oh, Isaiah Thomas. Okay, so NBA Live has him at 87 overall, while 2K has him at 82, and he's averaging 13 points per game. Now, I said in my roster update video, Isaiah Thomas shouldn't be that low, but he shouldn't be that high either. He is struggling. He's doing actually really, really bad right now. So, maybe he should be like an 84 overall. At number 4 is Jahlil Okafor. So, NBA Live believes he's a 79 overall, while 2K believes he's 73 overall, and he's averaging 6 points per game. They don't mention that he's barely playing at all. He's averaging like, I think, 12 minutes a game. That's not a lot. Jahlil Okafor doesn't get enough time considering how pretty decent he is. I think he should be better than a 73 overall. I also don't think he's as good as a 79 overall. At number 3 is Lonzo. I swear, he's always on one of these lists. 83 overall NBA Live, while 77 on 2K. I think they're both wrong. I think Lonzo's averaging 10 points per game, which is okay, but he's also close to averaging a triple-double-ish. For a rookie, that is. I mean, he's averaging 7 assists and 7 rebounds plus 10 points per game. That's really solid. Sure, they're not winning games, but he's not bad at all. I think he should be about like a 79 or an 80 overall. At number 2, it is Ricky Rubio. Now we're getting into the ridiculous. NBA Live believes Ricky Rubio is an 84 overall, while 2K believes he's a 77. He's averaging 12 points per game, which is a career high for him, but he's averaging the lowest assists he's ever had in his career. He would average about 9 to 10 assists a game. Now he's averaging 5. That's a pretty insane decrease. He should not be an 84 overall. And at number 1, it is Jeff Teague. Jeff Teague was an 85 overall in NBA Live and now a 78 overall in 2K. He's averaging 14 points per game, and people believe he's not as good as they expected him to be. This isn't actually a toss-up. I don't think he's an 85 overall at all, but he, I don't know, 78 overall is also kind of low. What do you guys think? And that's actually the end of this video, guys. Who do you guys think is rated way too high? Who do you guys think NBA Live rates really high, but 2K rates really low? Leave it in the comments below. If you like my channel, please give my channel a sub, and I'll see you guys next time.
Did you call back?